Coming up, we'll take a deeper look at the practical use of bots to infuse artificial intelligence within your customer relationship management. We're going to show you their evolution to intelligently interact with natural language and the ability to detect customer sentiment and intent, triage and transact customer engagement process to make opportunistic and personalized recommendations, and how you can quickly get bots up and running for yourself with the Azure Bot Service. I'm joined today by Giampaolo from the Cortana Intelligence team. Welcome.
Thank you. It's great to be here.
So there's been a ton of buzz around bots and artificial intelligence, but I know your team is really doing a lot of work to harness this technology and apply it to more practical use cases.
Yes. In a short time, we've greatly improved what bots can do. Just to illustrate the point that typical bot experience can follow quite a rigid and static flow where you needed to follow specific path taxonomies to get results. For example, here you've got the bot saying, okay, what can we do to help? And you're just answering by tapping the answer, but the bot could just see, no, sorry, I just need A, B, or C.
Right, and traditional bots are really limited in terms of the number of programmable interactions you might make, and you can't really deviate from that.
That's right. So now the good news is that we've got huge advances with the convergence of various key technologies. They allow us to build much more sophisticated agents leveraging the Azure Bot Service. Consider three different elements. The first one is interactivity and engagement, where we are able to redefine how bots interact with your business, with natural language understanding, and deep personalization. For example, with Microsoft Cognitive Services and these language understanding capabilities. The second aspect is bots intelligently performing actions within your business processes. So think about connecting with your CRM data with Dynamics 365 to know what's the profile of the users. And lastly is the ability for bots to be predictive, capitalizing on hidden insights within your data with big data, machine learning. And for example, think about Azure ML, Azure Machine Learning, running a churn model or finding upsell opportunities behind the scenes to help for better engagement. And of course, you can also integrate these core technologies with other third-party offerings.
Cool. Can we see a practical example of what you can now do with bots to really harness all these technologies?
Absolutely. In this example, I've just purchased a new car and I'm looking for a quote. I've got different ways to interact with my insurance company. I could search for the information into the website or directly call for an agent for assistance or even start chatting with a human agent. But as you mentioned, Jeremy, if all representatives are busy, bots become even more handy. So bots can support many different patterns or interactions with your customers. For example, I can ask the bot simple questions like, where are you located? And the interesting point is that we've got immediate responses as it's able to identify the intent of the question, regardless how I phrase it. And so anyone can easily have a very effective Q&A bot thanks to the Microsoft Cognitive Services, the one called Q&A Maker.
Right, and we're gonna show you Q&A Maker later so you can build your own bot.
So let's type, I need a car insurance because this is what I'm looking for. And what's going to happen is that the bot will understand again the intent and start the quote process. It's asking if I'm an existing customer. So I say yes, and a name to authenticate. So for this presentation, I'll be Alice Olson. And of course, we reduced the number of information which are required to go in this authentication path, but it will also ask me for social security number. And there are also new personalized ways for bots to recognize you. It could use my face and my voice thanks to Face API and Speaker Recognition API, and they could work as well to have this authentication process. Also, because it's integrating within Dynamics CRM, the bot is able to connect to business processes and retrieve customer information. You can see that the face is now loaded with Alice, and you've got more information. Using the CRM information, the bot is now able to provide an upsell scenario. And you can see there how you can take action through solutions that infuse intelligence within business processes.
Really, when you think about this is where the bot itself, being able to harness that intelligence, is really doing something that might take a long time or a relationship personally with your client. This is just doing that, pulling the data directly from something like Dynamics 365 and pulling that right into the chat.
Absolutely. And that something takes time to establish, time that we have now saved to be more effective. Now the bot is collecting additional information related to the car I just acquired. So what make of the car? As I've got friends working in the automotive industry, I don't want to make anyone jealous, so it will be Jumpy Car, a super nice, amazing model. And the model will be this one, which is...
Very long model name that you got there.
Awesome branding activity to have that.
Okay.
And so, of course, the year, let's say that I just acquired it last year. So now it's asking me something unusual to provide a car picture. And it seems to be a little bit unusual right now, but it's way more interesting because uploading pictures is critical for insurance companies, especially if you're having an accident. Mm-hmm. So I will say yes, and I will put the picture of my car. But guess what? I've got very dumb thumbs, and instead of selecting my car, what happened?
Oops, I just happens had all the time. You fat-fingered it.
My little nice dog. But the interesting point here is that it's using computer vision API as part of Microsoft Cognitive Services. This makes it possible to understand what's inside an image and verify if the content is appropriate. And it will loop again and again until it has a car. Look, it looks more like a dog sitting in the grass to me, which is pretty accurate. So it will re-ask again. And for this time, I will try to...
At least that dog will fit in this little car.
Absolutely. So now, this is just the start, because consider that in the future, what we could do. Thanks to deep learning techniques, you'd be able to upload a car picture and have the bot recognizing the brand and the model automatically without you putting the information. And so, of course, in the background now, the bot is able to pull together all the information provided and generating a quote, $146.50 per month.
Looks like a lot. It's more than I'm paying.
Yeah, but this number here includes input from my profile, risk assessment, system, even churn, and many more. So you can truly capitalize on insights hidden within and beyond your unique data, leveraging Azure Machine Learning. And lastly, this is the last part, the bot is asking me what I think about this. Let's say, as you mentioned, this is very expensive. Too much. And what's happening is that the bot can even detect the negative sentiment of the customer's response thanks to the cognitive services called Text Analytics API.
And what happened here was cognitive services actually look in the sentiment. And if you go silent, let's say you're really upset and you don't want to even respond to the bot, it'll even detect that and if you're not engaging.
Absolutely. And for example, here, it can bring in a human agent, Jen, to close the deal. And the good thing is that once added, she already has all the view of what happened by discussing with the bot.
So I'm going to play the part of Jane here and show you what I see. So in this case, I'm in CRM in Dynamics 365, and I can see Alice. I can see how long she's been active, her daughter's there. I see this beautiful yellow Giampi car that Giampaolo added earlier. I also see all the different interactions that that I've had with the bot as well. And I can even see this chat window that we were just working in. One of the cooler things here, though, is that I can take all of that information and start making suggestions for other offers using the intelligence and the machine learning directly through Dynamics 365 and all the integration that we just saw. Here I can see it's asking me if I want to cross-sell into personal injury protection.
That's right. And so we're leveraging here machine learning, of course, to identify the likelihood for the customer to leave the service, churn, and even making smart suggestions regarding other products the customer may wish to purchase thanks to the recommendation API. So contact centers will also be able to have a complete view of all the customer's requests and interactions aggregated in order to find smart insights. I can integrate this information with my visualization tools. And here with Power BI, I can see how bots are performing. The number of chats, the number of escalations, the chat performance with the funnel of engagement between active, successfully ending, escalated churn. Of course, what would be the activity if there are no handoff between an agent and the bot and the machine learning churn analysis behind the scenes. And the most interesting elements are also related to the key topics which are extracted thanks to text analytics. And you can see the real difference between what you would think of a customer going in a website and trying to understand what he has in his mind mm-hmm. and extracting automatically the information he's typing in a chat interface. And so this is where the power of cognitive services are really making a huge gap.
And these word clouds are really great for tracking sentiment.
Absolutely. And so let's just take a look at the global activity and realize that in Australia, something is unusual versus the average number of interactions we're having for the last weeks. Yep. And if I just click on it, you see that everything is changing. You've got way more escalation than expected, not so many business, but lots of chats. And you can see contortional insurance and expensive, which are popping up as key topics. And by cross and understanding deeper what's happening behind the scenes, we realized that one of our competitors, contortional insurance, just launched a new very aggressive campaign in which everything is 50% less. And so everyone is starting to engage with us saying, hey, you're too expensive. Let's have a deal.
Right. And we've also mentioned earlier, there's a number of technology that's really working behind the scenes to get all of this to work and bring all these different experiences together. You've just shown the reporting output of that, but in terms of the chat experience itself, I'm gonna have my web front end that you'll see here on the left. And what that's gonna do is it can either directly connect to cognitive services, which are gonna do things like detect speech if I'm talking to it, or the image recognition like we saw with your puppy in your car earlier. As I start to engage with any of the chat in the bot itself, what that's gonna do is go through the bot connector. And at that point, it's going to start to get triaged. Now, it's not going to go and start chatting and kind of sending back messages yet. It's going to receive that. That's going to go to cognitive services. And what that does basically is it's looking at language understanding intelligence service, LUIS as we call it, taking a look at text analytics in terms of sentiment that we saw earlier when you got angry about the price, the language translation if you wanted to use your native French, which might have been a little bit easier in terms of writing to different questions here. It would do that language translation dynamically on the fly. After that, what it's going to do is then take what it's learned and either go back to the chat dialogue, or in this case, like we saw here, maybe even pull data and information from Dynamics 365, information about your customer profile, and then opportunities that it can offer you up as it formulates the response. And then finally, it formulates the response back to the user with all that collected information. So all that stuff that we saw happened all instantly in the background. Now, I know that we saw Q&A, a part of Q&A earlier, but Microsoft just released the Q&A Maker. Is it easy to get up and running with that?
Absolutely. So let me show you how you can quickly set up a bot service to see questions and answer very quickly. Mm-hmm. So in many cases, you need to know that the questions and answer already exist somewhere or in your internal content or external site FAQ, URLs, or documents. So here, consider that Microsoft Q&A Maker is an easy-to-use REST API and web-based service that train AI to respond to users' questions in a more natural way. And you do not need to be an expert to train, manage, and use it for a wide range of solutions. So it was very simple graphical user interface I will show you by creating a new service. Mm-hmm. So straightforward, what's the name of the service? Let's stop mechanics. Okay. And you've got different choices. What's the URL of your company FAQ page, if you already have one?
And that's going to parse your FAQ page, maybe.
Exactly, on the go. Or no FAQ, no problem. Let's have a document you're going to update or starting it from scratch directly in the base. Here, I've got one FAQ I will show you very easy about a very nice product called Azure Machine Learning with simple questions, answers, repetitive that like 3-4 times just for the presentation.
Okay.
So I'm going to pick that one. And that's it. I'm just going next to create it automatically to have this knowledge base with paired questions with answers. And on the go, you can see now you've got 5 Q&A pairs with the different questions and all the different answers. And you can change them on the go and save and retrain and even publish. Okay. So I will show you in a second how you can test it. And if I click here, you see that you've got already the chat interface in which you can put already some questions answered. So you remember the first question we had in the Q&A?
It's quite the quiz. What is Azure Machine Learning?
So instead of saying what is Azure Machine Learning, because it's the exact same question, so you would have the same answer, let's try to be tricky and provide another complex question like, tell me more about machine learning. Let's put a question mark. So now what happened is that even if it wasn't the same question, thanks to the ability to understand what's the intent of the question, it mapped with the already existing answer and was able to say, OK, this is the answer. You've got the ability to select an alternate answer if it's not the right thing.
Right.
And you can even add additional questions. The only thing you need to do after adding this element is saving, retraining, and job is done.
Very cool. Without any code, you're able to get a Q&A bot up and running very quickly. This is a really fast-moving area, but can you tell us what's next?
Of course. So as of today, we've got more than 25 intelligent APIs and services in preview and general availability, but more services are coming very, very soon. And in this example, we showed you a text-based chat, but you could think about leveraging Bing Speech API, for example, to process speech to text and make it even more natural to have queries and answers. You could even think about leveraging the vision capabilities to understand who you are with face identification and even your emotions and automatically adjust the flow according to how your face would react.
So how would I get started if I want to start building these?
So you can quickly get started discovering Microsoft Cognitive Services site and Microsoft Bot Framework as well in the link below, as well as learning more about big data, advanced analytics, and artificial intelligence with the Cortana Intelligence Suite site.
Thanks, Giampaolo. You know, this is a really fast-moving space, and I look forward to trying all this stuff out myself. We'll keep watching out for more updates on Microsoft Mechanics. That's about all the time we have for today's show. Thanks for watching, and bye for now.